Mayor of Signorello III is the mayor of Roselle Park, New Jersey, and joins me now. Mayor, thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having me, Michael. Pleasure to be here.
I put in requests for Joseph Signorello I and the second. Unfortunately, I got bumped to you.
I mean, to be honest with you, the first and the second, they're the much better Joseph Signorellos. Everybody likes them more than me, so.
You look like a young guy to me. How old are you?
33 years old.
Nice. Well, good for you that you've stepped forward and are playing this leadership role. Tell me about initially Roselle Park, New Jersey. Where is it? How far are you from New York City?
Yeah, so, you know, we're probably without traffic. You could drive to the center of Manhattan in 30 minutes. You know, if you've ever flown through Newark Airport, we're about 10 minutes away from there. Closest city is Elizabeth, New Jersey. We're basically a suburb of Elizabeth. To your point, you know, when the Italians first came over, we've been in Roselle Park since 1904. All the old Italians were in Elizabeth and Newark. You know, Roselle Park was one of those first areas that you moved out to when you wanted a little piece of property for yourself and wanted to get out of the city. So that's how the first got his start over in Roselle Park.
I see. In other words, the original Joseph Signorello or the second, they moved out to one of those bedroom communities like Roselle Park.
That's right. Yep.
So I said earlier in the program that on my normal driving route, there are two properties that stand out. Neither is right in my neighborhood, but I see them routinely. And in each instance, the homeowners have homemade Trump signs. It's not like they went and ordered them. So they've spray painted signs that are negative toward Joe Biden, but lacking in obscenity. If I were to drive on Willow Avenue in Roselle Park, New Jersey today with you, the mayor, and we looked at a particular house, what would we see?
Yeah, so I think it actually makes sense if you don't mind just going back. So you would see 2 years ago a bunch of just pro-Trump signs up, right? Which, you know, pursuant to our, like, if you read our ordinance, there's nothing wrong with that, right? It's political. There was a lot of them, but fine. If you would drive by today, or I think post, whatever, a month and a half ago, you would see the Trump with giving the two-finger salute. you would see Biden. I don't know what I can say on air. Biden does something inappropriate and F Biden, right? So
F Biden, it's SiriusXM. We can say everything, but I'll just say F Biden and Biden blows.
That's right. Yep.
And it doesn't say F Biden. It drops the F bomb.
It drops the F bomb. Yeah.
Yeah.
So this was just, you know, and we have this ordinance on the books that predates me, right? So I've only been mayor for a couple of years now. You know, basically saying that profane signage in nature can't be displayed, particularly around, this is a block away from a school zone. So I don't get to pick and choose what codes get enforced. This, as with anything, when you're a small town mayor, if there's something that pops up, they come to me, right? My neighbor's grass is too long. My neighbor's playing too loud of music at night. Okay, hey, my neighbor's got this signage up and I got a bunch of concerned parents. I directed it to code enforcement and, you know, code enforcement saw fit to write a summons based on the way the ordinance reads. But, it's certainly not, I didn't wake up that morning saying, all right, I'm gonna go after political signage. This house has had political signage up for a while and there's been no issue.
So you're a D, but you're telling us you're not motivated by politics in this instance.
No, by no stretch. I mean, look, it sounds like cliche, but I'm everybody's mayor. I'm not just a mayor for Democrats or Republicans. The one thing you learn and this is a little bit of a kick in the butt for a millennial mayor, right, who comes and is really idealistic, is like potholes aren't Democrat or Republican. You just try to fix problems. As a matter of fact, some of the most vocal, my constituents have been the most vocal against these signage have been people who I know are Trump supporters or Republicans that just find it in poor taste in a small community.
So how many complaints would you say you've received about the homeowner who has, actually, is it her mother's house?
It's her mother's house, yeah.
Yeah. How many complaints would you say you've received about this particular property in the community for which you're the mayor that has the F Biden sign?
Yeah, so, you know, the initial blast was probably about 10 or something like that. Then there was a big Facebook thread. I'm sure a lot of you guys know in your local communities, there's the local message board, and that blew up. And then it quickly blew up into something that was kind of beyond Roselle Park. So I think the complaints started to drop once everybody knew that it was on the radar. But I would say the initial blast was like in pretty short order, about 10. And then there was a Facebook thread with thousands of comments on it.
Mayor, did you give thought to just doing nothing on the idea that when you take on the homeowner, in this case, it's a woman, when you take her on, all of a sudden, chances are he or she is going to dig in their heels. And whereas if you ignored it, you know, maybe she eventually just takes down the signs.
Yeah. You know, so here's the thing, right? Again, it's a small community, and I can say that our PD and our code enforcement made best efforts to try and, you know, come by and just ask for the signage to come down, right? So we didn't go straight to, I didn't go and write any tickets, but the administration didn't go straight to, you know, ticketing or fining this person. I think whether it was my ordinance that I passed or not, you know, sort of the mayor in this small little fiefdom of Roselle Park is the executive branch. And we have rules on the books, and we don't get to pick and choose, you know, how to apply those rules based on X, Y, or Z. If it was offensive and in violation of the code, I think we're beholden to upholding that. And, you know, our view has always been, if a superior court or a judge tells us that we are in violation of something like the First Amendment, then that's okay. We'll change the ordinance. But until then, you know, fair is fair, and the rules apply to everybody.
At the risk of listeners' eyes glazing over, let me tell them what Borough Code 3.8 says. It shall be unlawful for any person, firm, corporation, business association, club, group of individuals, or any combination of the aforementioned to knowingly photograph, act, pose for, print, sell, offer for sale, give away, exhibit, publish, or offer to publish, or otherwise distribute or pander, make, display, or exhibit any obscene material. And then obscenity is defined as any material, communication, or performance which the average person applying contemporary community standards existing within the municipality would find appeals to the prurient interest or depicts or describes in a patently offensive way, sexual conduct, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. To me, when I look at Borough Code 3.8 and the definition of obscenity, I say, well, yeah, that applies to F. Biden. I was surprised in reading in that in the Times coverage of this local dispute, there was a Seton Hall law professor who thinks that you and the borough are not on firm legal grounds. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, so I would say, and I'm not a lawyer, so this is kind of just me doing my best as mayor to kind of understand what case law has been in Supreme Court, you know, the way Supreme Court's ruled in the past. So obviously what's obscene changes from day to day, hour to hour, year to year. But there is a precedent where, especially within a school district, it makes sense to, I don't want to say tamper free speech, but be more careful with what free speech we use. And I want to be super clear that this residence is a block away from an elementary school, which kids pass by. And I think that, and the judge had ruled, although I think initially, and I would argue probably erroneously, all Biden signs, all the signs were ticketed. The judge had ruled that it was only the three that were offensive that were needed to be removed, which I think is the right ruling. But, you know, I just think, look, I'll give a perfect example, right? So when most news publishing organizations post pictures from that house, they blur out those particular signs, right? And they do that because they don't want, you know, either their personal viewers to get turned off or violations themselves, right? So, my argument would be is if the New York Times or the Star Ledger is going to blur those pictures, you know, the idea that we can't, you know, censorship is way too strong of a word for this. The fact that we can't regulate this a little bit for our neighbors and municipality feels a little bit absurd to me.
It's a good argument. By the way, I'm holding today's print edition of the New York Times, and they opted to go with one of the cleaner banners that she hangs on the house and not the F-bomb or the Biden blows, which I think exactly. makes your point.
Yeah.
And a different issue that I'll raise with my own audience is whether the F-bomb has lost its sting. There was a case years ago when Bono was given an award. I forget which award it was, and came out and said, this is effing brilliant. And then the FCC stepped in and the debate became one of, well, what does that really mean when you use that word today? Has it been offered so often that it loses its sting? But I can completely understand how you don't want that sign a block away from an elementary school. All right, next time that I call, I will be calling for Joseph Signorello IV. Okay, so we're going to keep this line moving. But Mayor, I thank you so much for sharing your thoughts on this local controversy. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, it was a pleasure. Thanks for having me on.